Multiple outbreaks of multiple illnesses hitting children all across the area tonight. KMBC 9's Martin Augustine is looking into what's going on. He joins us live from Children's Mercy. Martin?
Well, Larry, this is typically a time of year when those viruses and bacteria that make our kids sick begin to roll in. It's just that this time around, the sicknesses are showing up in greater numbers. Now, doctors and nurses here at Children's Mercy Hospital are compiling some of those numbers, notably about a respiratory virus called RSV. Now, they've been testing children for RSV here since October. That's about when RSV begins to show up. And of 423 children, 32% have tested positive for RSV. Now, while doctors expect to see RSV now, those numbers, hospital staffers say, are relatively high for this time of year. In most children who catch RSV, the symptoms appear like a cold, but the virus is hardest on the very young. I spoke with one parent tonight whose toddler twins have RSV.
At 2 a.m., I woke up and heard Fiona, you know, moving around, and then I heard her start to cough, and I ran into the room, and she was coughing and gasping and choking, and I said, okay, we got to go do another breathing treatment because, you know, you're having trouble.
I also spoke tonight with Dr. Kenneth Duncan. He's a pediatrician with Northland Pediatrics Associates. He says, indeed, he's seen quite a bit of RSV. Now, the best prevention for RSV, he says, is like prevention for a cold. Lots of hand washing, lots of covering up those coughs and sneezes. Now, also, whooping cough continues to be a problem in parts of our region, notably in Johnson and Douglas counties. Coming up tonight at 10, we'll show you just how widespread that problem is. Reporting live, Martin Augustine, KMBC 9 News.
Martin, thank you. We have links about the risks and prevention of RSV up now on our website, KMBC.com.